The colorful lantern world of the 2022 Zigong International Dinosaur Lantern Festival. There were an eye-catching group of lamps inspired by an ancient Chinese myth. A giant Jingwei goddess hat that integrated sound, lighting, and other elements became the most memorable and popular lantern of this fair.
当时做设计的时候，也没想到他会让那么多人喜欢。经历这个爱情故事，实际上是非常打动人的，非常刻骨铭心。大海把他的老公淹死了，然后他就伤心的就变成了一只鸟，就去雕了一个石头，就想把这个大海填平，就报仇嘛。
一塌无比的头像，二十二米高一个，一个大的头像，然后让人非常震撼。我就觉得有同情，有想象。每个人在下面都会拍一张照看一下，然后可能每个人都会去想象跟自己有什么关系，有什么情感的这种对接。我觉得灯光不要装得太亮，往下面走。李薇薇，a
lantern designer who graduated from Sichuan Fine Arts Institute, likes to innovate in the traditional lantern industry. He launches something new at the Zigong International Dinosaur Lantern Festival every year. After his Jingwei goddess lantern went viral last year, he turned to traditional Chinese culture for inspiration again this year. Today, he and his team are finalizing the glasses-free 3D content.
<音>人物的表情是没办法的，包括其实如果放大的话，人头就那么大，人头那么大的话，我们用的这个版本都还算是比较清晰的，咱们现在用的是辽宁博物馆那版本，因为它洛神赋的原画已经没有了，看不到。我们想的整个这个洛神赋这个题材呢，就像去年的《山海经》一样，它是一个很优美的爱情故事。第二个呢，我觉得 他应该用这种现代人的眼光来看待这个中国的最传统的这个文化。我们加了大量的这个现代的科技技术，裸眼 3D 啊、AR 啊这些东西，然后符合这个现代人的审美习惯。The
history of the Zigong Lantern Festival can be traced back to Tang and Song dynasties. The thriving salt industry formed an economic base that lantern festivals could build on. The Shenhai Well, an important cultural relic under state protection, is a living fossil of a local salt well. It is also the first well over 1 kilometer deep in the world. The well not only produces brine, but also gas, providing fuel to boil salt. After more than 180 years, the well is still producing salt. Zigong is also deemed the hometown of dinosaurs. Zigong Dinosaur Museum is a large museum built on the world-famous Dashanpu Dinosaur Fossil Site. Its collection includes almost all known dinosaur species in the Jurassic period, and it is one of the places with the largest collection of Jurassic dinosaur fossils in the world. Salt history, dinosaurs, and colorful lanterns are the three wonders of Zigong. So Zigong Lantern Festival has another name, the International Dinosaur Lantern Festival.
Zigong lanterns are ingeniously designed with unique materials. To make their lanterns stand out, early craftsmen try their best. Porcelain tableware, glass bottles, silkworm cocoons, and silk can all be used to make lanterns. Traditional techniques combined with sound and lighting technologies make lanterns stand out.
我身边的这件灯具呢，叫做瓷器宫灯王，它的全身是使用了60000多件瓷器捆扎而成。这件灯具呢，是用到了这个瓷器捆扎技艺，那这个也是自贡彩灯的一个特色了。它最开始呢是来源于以前商人在售卖瓷器的时候会用这个棉线将瓷器捆扎带给顾客方便携带。我们这个瓷器灯的捆扎技艺也是由此而来。
Zigong Lantern Festival as a local folk culture with a long historyWas included in the National List of Intangible Cultural Heritage in 2008. Xiong Biao, 57 years old, is a tradition bearer of Zigong lantern making techniques. His father, Xiong Wendong, was the first generation designer at Zigong Lantern Festival, also known as the Master of Chinese Lanterns.
这是我父亲的一个作品，也就是我们叫宫灯，走马灯，里面这个绘画也是我父亲的作品。然后我们采取新的技术，这个内裱从里面裱糊，展现我们自贡这个传统这个造型工艺。我父亲去年过世以后，他把他几十年遗留下来的手稿全部交接给我，一定要我传承下去。我父亲的手稿很丰富，他这个光是花卉就几十个国家的国花，这个花心放灯他都专门注明了一下，这个灯就放在这个花心里面，颜色配色等等，这个都全部写得很清楚。国外市场我们针对这个阿拉伯风情的一些建筑把它做成灯，现在我们已经做了一部分出来，很漂亮。这个就是我们还原我父亲的手稿阿拉伯风情的花灯。这个花灯不分国界的，每个国家都喜欢，因为我们几次参加西博会，国外客户一看到反映他们当地的花灯，就下来跟我们马上下订单，他说你跟我生产几千个这种花灯，我拿回去送他的亲朋好友。所以说现在我们这后面的灯就越做越小，就把它做得更小有利于携带，运输也很方便。
In recent years, Zigong's huge lantern sets made their name at home and abroad. Many lantern enterprises focus on the design and production of large sets, while smaller lanterns have become neglected due to costs, market demand, and other factors. But Xiong remains dedicated to innovating and passing on small craft lanterns.
这个活花鱼从里面裱糊，这个展现丝架这个造型工艺。这个小灯最主要是我们要展现一个制作工艺，还有一个不光是节庆日大家都去看的花灯，而且平时要进百姓之家，每个老百姓都能够买得起，都能够观赏到，能够欣赏到，所以说我们把它浓缩成小的灯进家庭。花灯也是带来光明，带来吉祥， 带来好的兆头，都希望把这个彩灯、小的花灯、各种造型的花灯进入千家万户。
The Spring Festival is the year's most important festival for the Chinese. It's also the busiest time for Wansong Tao. The lantern industry fluctuates with seasons. The 1 or 2 months before the Spring Festival is the peak season for all lantern enterprises.
We 山西的，就今年春节的一批货，我们车间那边加工完了以后，完成90%多，然后到现场去组装，工期特别紧。
我们这批货都是为了春节赶的，这几天很忙，加班加到9点半。我是云南的，结婚在这自贡10多年了，今年要带着孩子回家过年。有5年没回去了。
其实那个彩灯行业哈，从业人员，他们的家庭地位也好，社会地位也好，也是比较受尊敬。像年底，很多人哈就说你这干什么呢？说做花灯的，大家都有羡慕的眼光。他们虽然就累，可能年底的话就两三个月的话呢，收入5-6万。就2-3个月5-6万，其实大家都还是比较羡慕嘛。
In Zigong, with a population of more than 2 million, 40,000 to 50,000 people work in the lantern industry all year round, and more than 100,000 work seasonally. Almost 80% of lantern festivals in China.Are organized by people from Zigong. Wan has been working in the industry for over 30 years. He witnessed Zigong lanterns making breakthroughs and making its way to the top of the industry.
Zigong 花灯它有别于其他流派的花灯，最大的一个特点就是它塑形特别好。它里面的一些骨架哈，就是通过那种铁丝造型焊接。然后成型以后，然后里面装灯裱糊，然后这个工艺是在所有花灯流派里面，自贡工艺是做的最好最极致的。通过铁丝焊接出来里面的一些结构的美哈，它其实单纯来讲也是一个作品。
As the tradition bearer of Zigong lantern making, Wansong Tao seldom makes lanterns himself now. Instead, he teaches skills and manages the project. This creative and dynamic industry is attracting more young people. These young designers know their generation better and their designs are modern.
登宝
在呢。
你今年几岁了？
我是2018年5月出生的，你可以算算我几岁了。
登宝。你介绍一下彩灯的历史。
想到历史，瞬间不想上课啊。
创意方面，其实年轻人就他天马行空的东西更多一些，所以说现在我们行业里面的设计师。基本上都是年轻人，90后、00后的比较多，而且我们也跟，美术学院的也有一些交流。
之前的，就是说这个。
自贡 lantern industry has developed from manual workshops to become one of the manufacturing pillars of the city. For many lantern enterprises, talent.Is the key to their long-term development. In 2018, Sichuan University of Science and Engineering in Zigong opened its Lantern School, the first and only one of its kind in China. Students from all over the country are here to study and practice in a professional and a systemic way. They will become the backbone of lantern art in Zigong and the whole country. Zigong International Dinosaur Latin Festival is the most intensive one so far. Li Weiwei is not sure whether his work, The Goddess of the Luo River, can be completed on time. These days, he goes to the production site to check the progress as often as he can.
This人物基本上也就是非常到极致了，就是美术师，然后工人，还有设计都是一流的，应该是原画也画得好，造型也造得好，然后后期处理也好。
开幕式是哪天吧？十号怎么做得完吧？今天是五号了，四号了。你看往年还有十天的话是什么效果？基本上都全部该立起来的都立起来了。没有哪一年是很充足的，都很荒。然后再加上如果再下两天雨的话，那就完蛋了，很麻烦。现在还好疫情解开了嘛。 这屋里外要好一些。你把鼻孔滴在喷一下，鼻孔滴下。嗯。对。扫一扫。嗯，可以。
像我负责的这一块的话，主要是对它的那个色彩效果的一种还原，还会对设计图进行一些自己的一些艺术升华呀这些。今年的话，它的那个整体工期要比往年要少十几二十天，所以我们今年是特别的紧凑，每天除了吃饭的话，感觉连厕所都。 上不了一个，然后就要赶着来把这些东西给做出来。小时候的话，每年过春节都会跟家人啊一些一起逛灯会。我小的时候就觉得这些东西就亮着灯特别的漂亮，特别的好看，因为还有一种就是节庆的那种氛围在里面，就感觉每到看灯会的时候，就是全家人一起团聚的时候，就心里面特别的开心。 反正每次都特别的期待，然后就想着长大了也会做到这个行业，可以自己做的话多好。然后毕业之后就留在了自贡，在自己的家乡做彩灯。
The short time means thousands of workers have to work at the construction site every day. To ensure the Lantern Festival opens on time, they come here early, go home late, and eat at the site.
早上也是赶到八点钟。八点，九点。
哦，有一个姑娘整13个小时在工地上站着啊。公司跟我报销过去烟袋的那种吗？可以啊，没问题。晚上回去洗个澡就睡吧。
要还要回去画图嘛，有些时候。对，这边卖，这边工资嘛。
Zigong, a small city southeast of China's Sichuan province, is just like any other small Chinese city in the day. It's slow and the people are relaxed. But at night, the whole city lights up. The dinosaur-themed amusement park turned into a night kingdom full of laughter. National Dinosaur Latin Festival is just one day from opening. The goddess of the Luo River is finally completed, thanks to the efforts of all the workers. Li Weiwei came to the site early in the morning. He's about to check the glasses-free 3D part to do some last-minute adjustment.
我到里面看一下，这儿看着好看，不要动了，就这样。我们做只有二十二天吧，最多的时候有九十几个人。 太难了，还好中途没下雨，天气还比较好。今天已经卖票了，今年疫情打开，生意一定好。洛神部的核心，它像就像去年的山海经一样，它是一个很优美的风景的一个传统故事。 它有很多元素，有这个鸵鸟凤凰，然后有几个非常有名的这个人物，自动的这种很精细的工艺去表现这种南北朝时代的一种风范，做成那种国潮风，符合现代年轻人这种，特别是这个八零后九零后零零后的这种审美，所以这个要看到传统，要看到这种年轻审美的色彩。 所以在这个通道上面设计是也很难，时间关键是时间很紧。最后我觉得打个八十分吧，只能打个八十分。The
29th Zigong International Dinosaur Latin Festival finally lit up. Lantern festivals are the earliest nighttime economy in China. Visiting the Lantern Festival as a family is an important activity during Chinese festivals. This year's festival connects the real world with the virtual world, creating China's first story plus gamification immersive Lantern Festival. Sound, lighting, digitalization, virtualization, the integration of technology has turned the festival into a theme park for young people.
今年第29届自贡国际恐龙灯会，我们的主题是梦想之光，千灯之城。这一届灯会啊，就大量的我们传统的年味的呈现啊，在主线上，我们也把中国的这个传统文化做了一个呈现。 另外呢，我觉得呢，还有一个新的特点，就是我们今年给 IP 方的合作，这样让我们的这个自贡彩灯呢，有让更多的这个年轻人喜欢，这也是我们对未来的这个彩灯的如何影响更多的这个年轻的消费者做了一个探索。
自贡灯会源于唐宋，兴于明清，盛于当代。那么自古以来，自贡的老百姓，他们对美好生活的向往，对家的这个团圆呢，都非常的看重。今年的彩灯呢，它也是光明之灯，寄托着我们要驱除了三年的一个变魔啊，让大家希望过上一个更加红红火火的日子。
Zigong Lantern Festival has turned from a local folk custom to a large-scale festival event. Every year, bright lights adorn this city that never sleeps. These shining lights bring generations of Zigong people beautiful memories. Here, they believe that lanterns light people's way to prosperity.